Welcome to the channel Data Science Demonstrated. In this video, you will understand on what is customer segmentation as well as go through various data science and artificial intelligence implementation techniques. I will also show you a no-code demo which will help you see customer segmentation in action. So friends, let us jump in. Generally, large companies have got millions of customers, and without segmentation, it is very difficult to create marketing strategies or customer communications. However, segmentation allows to create group of customers who are similar, and this can help businesses to optimize their marketing and product development efforts as well as better serve the customers. In order to master customer segmentation, you need to understand the different types of segmentation, what algorithms to select, and how to interpret the segments. The most common type of segmentation are transactional segmentation, behavioral segmentation, and segmentation based on personal attributes. The segmentation algorithms can be as simple as an RFM algorithm or complex algorithms such as deep learning autoencoder. For interpretation, we can use various techniques such as radar chart or parallel coordinate visualization. In this video, I will show you the transactional type of segmentation, RFM, k-means clustering, and parallel coordinate visualization techniques. The other segmentation types and techniques will be covered in subsequent videos. So let's get started on the transactional segmentation type. The transactional segmentation type is also called as the RFM segmentation, which stands for recency, frequency, and monitoring. I will demonstrate this segmentation type with retail transaction data coming from an online retailer. The data has got information such as the invoice number, the product purchased, the quantity purchased, as well as the price. The invoice date can be used to calculate the recency, which means then when was the last time customer purchased something. The invoice number can be used to calculate the frequency of purchases which are made by the customer, and the total price can be used to calculate the monetary value. With RFM calculations, you can convert the retail transaction data into RFM information for each customer. As an example, you can have the data which has got the days since the last purchase was made, the frequency which is measured in invoice per month, and the monetary value which is the total of all purchases in a month. The RFM calculations are done for each customer. The time frame could be monthly or yearly or any other time frame which is required by business. Using the RFM values, the customers can be segmented using the clustering algorithm. The segments can then be interpreted to understand what they mean. For example, you can have segments such as low RFM or medium RFM or long time since the last purchase was made, frequent customers or high value customers. Let us now look into some visuals with some actual data. Shown here is the result of clustering algorithm. Each dot corresponds to a customer. The color of the dot corresponds to the segment. Now there are in total 5 segments and each customer is assigned to a segment. We can hover over the dots to see the segment to which the customer is assigned. Let us now interpret on what these segments mean. A visualization which can help to understand the segments is called the parallel coordinate visualization, which is shown over here. You can see vertical lines for recency, frequency, and monetary. All the values have been standardized between 0 and 100. The rightmost vertical line is for the segments or also called as clusters. Let us now select the cluster 0 to see what it means. Now, cluster 0 is for the customers who have high recency value, meaning that they have not made any purchases since long time. So a marketing strategy for these customers could be on how to bring them back and potentially make some discounted offers. Cluster 1 is for the customers who have high monetary value, and for these customers we can create a loyalty program which will motivate them to continue purchasing. Cluster 2 is for the customers who have low recency, meaning they have bought something recently but with low frequency and monetary value. A marketing message to ask about their purchase experience could be useful. Cluster 3 is for the customers who have medium recency and low frequency and monetary value. And these customers are potentially who are likely to churn and stop purchasing. So it would be useful to prevent the churn by making some exciting offers to them. Cluster 4 is for the customers who have high frequency, and these are regular customers. And once again, a loyalty program could be useful for such customers. Let me now jump into the demo. I will give you the demo using my platform experiencedatascience.com. It is a no-code platform to learn data science, and you can find the link in the description. The customer segmentation demo using RFM is located over here. You can also try it out for yourself. It is a guided demo, and you can hover over the tip button to see what to do at each step. All right, let me first set up the data which I'll be using in the demo. This will take a while. And now the data set is available. So let me select it and then select analytics. Let me first show you some sample data. I will select a few records to show. Let me also select all the columns and run. All right, now you see the sample data and you see the customer ID, the invoice, and the purchase item details. Now let me do the RFM modeling. And here I will select the customer ID as the field on which we want to calculate the RFM values. The column which will be used to calculate the recency is the invoice date. Let me take the field invoice to calculate the frequency of purchase and the total price to calculate the monetary value. I will also save the output so that we can use it for subsequent steps. All right, now let me run this. And in a while, the RFM analysis is available. As you can see that for each customer, we have the recency, the frequency, and the monetary value. So for example, for the customer C12347, there is a recency value of 16, which means that the customer made the last purchase 16 days back. He has made one purchase in the month, which is indicated by the frequency column, and the value of purchase was 711, which is indicated by the monetary column. Okay, let us now use this data for clustering. Now, before I go into clustering, I need to change the data set. Here you see the online retail data, but now you also see a new data set which has appeared, which is indicated by this particular data set. Now, this is the output of the RFM analysis. So now let us select it for the clustering purposes. The clustering algorithm which I'll be using here is called K-means algorithm. Let me first select the columns recency, frequency, and monetary as the inputs to the clustering algorithm. I'll try to make 5 clusters, and when it comes to the output, we can visualize the output of clustering as a 2D scatter plot. But we have 3 fields in the data, so we need to compress it into 2D using dimensionality reduction technique called PCA. So let me select PCA, which will make this possible. I can also select some few other settings for some advanced visualization techniques such as spotlighting. And let me also save the data set as we'll be using it for further analysis. Now let me run the clustering, and in a while I will obtain the visualization. So here you see the output of clustering, and this is the visualization which was shown earlier. Okay, now let me move to parallel coordinate visualization, which we will use to interpret the clusters. Once again, let me change the data set. I see 3 data sets over here, and I will select the data set which corresponds to the output of clustering. Let me select it and then select the parallel coordinate visualization. Now for parallel coordinate visualization, we need to select the columns with numerical values. So I will select the recency, frequency and monitoring. I need to also select a categorical or a non-numerical column, and let this be the column which has got the name of the cluster or the segment. Now there are many records for a cluster, so we will try to aggregate all the records, and we can choose to average all the RFM values for a cluster. Now there is one more technique to be applied called the min-max scaler. The values of recency, frequency and monetary are all at different scale. The recency is in days, the frequency is in invoices per month, and the monetary is dollar per month. However, in order to interpret the clusters correctly, it is important that all are at the same scale. So we can use the min-max scaler, which will convert all the values between 0 and 100. Low values will be near 0 and high values will be near 100. So let me go ahead and select the scaler as min-max scaler. Now let me run this, and in a while you will see the parallel coordinate visualization which was shown earlier. So my friends, that was the segmentation using the RFM technique. Stay tuned for the next parts on segmentation which I'll be posting soon. In the meantime, please do subscribe to the channel, comment and like the video.